do this video, I guess I need to change my introduction lines, because often I keep saying I'm going to do this YouTube video or what have you. The question I wanted to talk about: does autism annoy people, and do people with autism become annoying? One of the things that you could say is that having autism has, I guess, an element of depression to it as well. And people tend to, from what I can see, avoid autistic people, because I know from my own experience, as Dr. Tony Atwood says, I'm used to people avoiding me and being pushed away. And I find that, you know, that's why I grow orchids. That's why I grow orchids and I do gardening, do a bit of gardening and things like that. Doesn't mean that I'm limited to those skills. I do them as a pleasure activity, because growing orchids, doing gardening, also loving animals like pets, dogs and cats and things like that, is a way to, or even just seeing animals as a way to connect. You know, like we people have so many friggin' issues. Like, there's a guy on Facebook, for example, and he was talking about how he had to cut toxic people out of his life and how he couldn't handle people that were difficult or what have you. And he said he cut them out. And he said that even with friends that he had, he did this. And I said, well, I asked him, I said, what exactly is a friend to you? And then I got blocked and deleted. And the thing is that I often feel I'm never asked what I want. I have people that are around me that try to expect me to be what they want me to be, but I'm never allowed to be who I am. Nobody's ever sat down and actually asked me what I did in my life, how I grew up. Hey, Garry, you're turning 50 years old this year. That's a milestone, isn't it? What did you do in those 50 years? Apart from just the sort of basic questions, you know, just asking, hey, having a conversation, what have you done with your life? What do you feel that frustrates you? How do you feel about the way that people don't treat you very nicely at times? And I must admit that we all are, and I'm not saying that I've been particularly angelic in my way of talking to people, but we never really ask. We never talk anymore. I mean, it's not just about me, but there's never stories shared about what was it like growing up? What was it like 50 years ago? You know, the younger men today don't even know, apart from their mobile phones, what a rotary telephone is. So many get so easily offended and take the defensive front. When I was 30, or I was 20 when they were born or something like that. And I think that I do, and I'm going to say this, I think that in our school system, instead of talking about all this other stuff that's going on, there should be basic psychology taught in schools and in workplaces or in universities. There should be one component that's compulsory in the syllabus of a school is psychology. An understanding of psychology. Because if we have an understanding of psychology, we then know how to communicate with each other better, which we don't do. You know, one of the things that I do to shake people up is I say good morning. When I went out, and people say to me, I should belong to a church. Why? Where does it say in the Bible that we need to belong to a church? When I went out on Good Friday, I went out into the rainforest and I saw people and I felt I was the church to them. How are you this morning? Bless you. Hope you have a great day. When you go and have a coffee, I am the church. If the thing that concerns me is getting stuck into a church and being pushed around, controlled, and sort of having no escape to what I'm expected to be. That's why I feel like, and hey, I may not, you know, I may not be intelligent at chess, but I invest a lot of my intelligence in navigating this lunatic world that we're in. All the different rules and regulations, all the different things that can and can't be done, all the differences in human behavior. That in itself requires intelligence to get through. I think chess is a game of strategy, but it doesn't mean that because you can't play it very well, doesn't mean that you you're lacking intelligence. A lot of people, especially young people, younger men as well, they actually are checking themselves and their insecurities through other people. How many times do you hear issues all the time? You want to catch up with someone, oh, I've got something on, something's happening, I don't feel up to it today, or something else is happening. It comes down to self-discipline. You know, get yourself out of bed early in the morning. Go for a walk. Get up early. Make your bed. Go out and plan what you're going to do for the day. Say good morning. Don't spend all the time on your phone. Say good morning to someone. Shakes people up. Gets them out of their comfort zones. Good morning, how are you? Good afternoon, how are you? Hello, how are you? People are on their phones. Good morning, how are you? Oh, hello. How are you going? It gets people away from the distractions of the materialistic world. And what did Jesus actually say? He said, what does it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? But if we have a basic understanding of psychology in the school systems, in the universities, in the TAFE colleges or wherever else, in the workplaces, how much better would it be for people to be able to get on with each other? We often say things now, or people say things, especially through the social media, that sometimes are very direct into the jugular, and people get offended. But how often do we need to just, you know, don't, for the churches, don't always ask people to the church. Ask someone out for a cup of coffee. Ask them out to go for a walk somewhere. It doesn't always have to be in the building. Say to someone, hey, I'd like to catch up with you. Do you want to come for a cup of coffee? We could meet up at the cafe around the corner or wherever it might be. Do you want to come for a walk? I know a great walk we could do. Don't always go to the building all the time. You know, wonder why the secular world, you wonder why the secular world is turning away from the churches? Because the churches are living too much in the buildings. We need to get out into the communities. Go out, every Sunday, even on a Sunday, you'd be surprised at how many people are out needing to find God in their day-to-day walks. Just that person on the track that's, you know, taking a Sunday walk, saying good morning to him or her. You might think, well, it's not going to do anything, but that might be just a blessing. That person just may need that acknowledgement to get themselves through the day. What did Jesus say himself? Go out and baptize nations in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And the thing is that I often find that people put boundaries around themselves and I'm expected to respect their boundaries, but when I put my boundaries around, I'm criticized. I'm told that I'm unfair and unjust, and they put boundaries around when I contact them. We all need to communicate with each other. We need to communicate. Basic psychology training would be a great start to that. First mental health first aid would be a start to that as well. And I've often thought about doing a mental health first aid course because I see people, I see younger people, younger men in particular, and I try to be a role model or whatever. I may not be a role model. It's not about me, it's about strength in Christ in me. But, you know, so many people on Facebook and LinkedIn block, or just don't connect. But we can all connect by just saying to each other, good morning, good afternoon, how's your day going? Not just a text message all the time. An actual face-to-face encounter. Would you like to catch up for a coffee? I know a great coffee shop. Would you like to go for a walk? I know a great track to go walking. Get into nature. Get away from all the distractions of the world. Get away from all the materialism. Don't think that it's always about you or me. When we get out into nature, we see God, we feel God. Often I feel like with myself, you know, that's what I do, like I grow orchids, right? I just find that people can be very, very uncaring I think people try to help, but they don't know how to help. They don't know how to communicate. And it just comes down to communication. Just simply communicating. One of the best things is a dog. When people, you have to see a dog, someone's having a dog, have a conversation about the dog. How often does that dog have a meal a day? How often does that dog have a bath? How often does that dog get exercise? Hasn't that dog got a lovely gold coat? Is he so friendly? When I meet people, right, even in coffee shops, wherever it might be, the dog's more friendly than the person. What does that say? The other day I went up and I was patting a Kelpie cross dog out at Sanford in the coffee shop. And this dog came up and wanted to be patted and given affection and hugged and everything. But his owner just sat there, not with very much conversation. But if people don't communicate with each other, then, and I'm not saying that I'm perfect, none of us are perfect. If we put aside the issues and we just say, it's not all about me, it's not all about my worries, it's not all about what's going on in my life. And we focus on something else. It might be the dog, it might be the cat, it might be the bird, it might be the orchid, it might be the something else. I think people need to get out of churches, basically, and get into the community. Go out. I mean, if a church is so hungry for individuals to come to it, or an individual, then is it God pleasing, or is it people pleasing? You know, if I was people pleasing, you know, what did Jesus say about that? He said that, don't worry about the clothes you wear or the food you eat, but to be concerned about each other. He said, look at the birds of the air, for they neither sow nor reap nor store their treasures, yet our Heavenly Father feeds them. Are you of more value than they? But over this Easter weekend, again, think about Genesis 3, where man didn't listen to God. Adam didn't listen to God. He chose to listen to the world through the woman and eat of the tree of good and evil. But what did God do? He brought himself through his son Jesus to be crucified on that tree, to raise Jesus up for all of us. And I think that, and I feel that we need to be not just focused on what church, or for those Christians who go to church, not to be focused on, oh yes, I go to St. Joseph's or whatever church it might be, and I don't communicate with anyone else. It's not a matter of what city the church is in, it's just anywhere. You know, and I think that we can be the church. Jesus even said that he was the church. You know, he said that the temple would be destroyed in 3 days, referring to himself. What did he also do? He went into the house of worship and drove out the moneylenders and overturned the tables. He didn't go in there just to say, hey, that you guys can do what you want. Instead of worshipping God, they worship materialism and money. So I think that there should be more respite. You know, look at retreats, for example. Churches should have retreats with other churches or you know, be connecting with the community, like they could be at Mount Tambourine, which has Christian facilities up there. It has accommodation facilities. But if people stay stuck in the church, in the building, then it becomes increasingly secular, because there's us and them. We need to be the church ourselves. We need to get out into the community. We don't always talk about the Bible. We don't always talk about scripture. Romans 14:1 says, receive one week in faith, welcome him, but not over opinions and doubtful things. You know, when you're around friends or you talk to, I was down the Burley markets, you know, I see younger guys around and I always try to be friendly to them, to encourage them. Just, you know, I mean, it's the same with women too, but with guys, to encourage them, to let them know that they too are individuals. And yes, we may annoy people, but didn't Jesus annoy people by the fact that he spoke so highly of God? The world doesn't understand it, it can't cope with it. But let us focus on the love of God. And, you know, I think it's good to be beside the sea. It's good to be out in the mountains. It's good to be out in nature, especially with all the things that are going on in the world. I may not be, I'm not saying that I don't understand a lot of the younger guys, you know, like I look back to when I was 30, and yes, it was a different age back then, but I look at a lot of the younger guys now and I think, how do you guys communicate? You're always on a phone all the time. Do you ever reach out to older people? Do you ever actually ask someone that's older what was life like when they were 30? Do you ever actually take time to reflect, especially with older people? Often it's difficult, isn't it? We can't always just sort of ask people openly, how was your life? What did you do? What was it like back then? Because we get so busy. But if we just focus on, you know, the things that we can achieve and what we can do to communicate, we can do to be a caring community, that makes a life a lot better. That rather than boasting, not to boast about what our church has done, or what a church has done, or whether someone's been, it's a high profile figure that's been baptized or whatever. Focus on Christ. It should always be on Christ. Not on celebrities, on Christ. You know, like if I know Hugh Jackman's, I believe he's a Christian. If Hugh Jackman came into your church and he got baptized, he's just like everyone else. Christ is the one we look to. Always focus on Christ. That's what we need to be doing. And how often do we not do it? How often do we need to focus on Christ and be, what's that passage? It says, I think 1 John 1:12, that says, for as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, to those who believe in his name. We are all God's children. The person that's intelligent more than you and I is God. Just because someone plays chess better than someone else doesn't mean that they're more intelligent or inferior. A person's navigation through life and use of intelligence is not an inferiority. And I had a psychologist say to me once that I was in the low percentile. I had no more intelligence than someone in grade 12. And I felt like saying, what gives you the right to say that? You know, it all needs to focus on love. We all need to focus on the strength of Christ. And maybe some churches should hold some chess games. Maybe playing chess is a great way of getting people thinking, getting away from the politics, because the chessboard itself has some connections to God itself. You don't have to be great at chess. Just play a few games and, or checkers or Monopoly or something. Games to get people thinking. Even quoits, lawn bowls, all these sorts of games that encourage stimulation. So, Easter blessings. What are your Easter blessings? What does a rabbit and what does an egg, because rabbits don't lay eggs, do they? What does an egg and what does a rabbit have to do with Christmas? Oh, sorry, with Easter. Fertility. The word Easter, I believe, comes from estrogen. Procreation. I think that's where it comes from. I believe. I think. But the actual cross itself. Hot cross buns, great for Easter. Great Easter. You know why hot cross buns are good for Easter? Because they've got the cross on them. And you can break them and share them with other people, which is what I did with the Regis the other day in aged care. Break the bread, share it with others. That's what Jesus did when he was at the Last Supper. So hot cross buns are a great means of making them a bit pagan. I do believe that they were invented through a Catholic minister or what they call priest or something. Great to have hot cross buns, cross on them, share them among people, break them up. Say to a brother, hey, I want to break bread with you. How often do you get refused when you request that to them? So sadly, people don't want to break bread anymore. All you got to do is break the bread, share it with someone. It's not asking for anything more than that. It's just sharing the bread, the bun. And get on with what you're doing in the day. It's a symbolism, isn't it? Anyway, my thoughts for this Easter Saturday. Thanks very much for watching. God bless you.